Question three, cash budget. Like I said, budgeting is a strong area which we cannot jump away from. So I was saying the examiner can ask you to do a cash budget or they can ask you to do other functional budgets. Take a question. The following data and estimates are available for ABC Limited for June, July, August 2017. My tables are sales, wages, overhead, and the information as you can see. The figures as you can see. Alright. The following information is available materials. June, July, August, and September. June, July, August, and September. Please, pardon that. Opening inventory. You can find it like this. Material usage, like this. Now, additional information. 10,000 units of sales are for cash. The balance is received in the following month. The amount received in June for May, say, is 29,500,000. 29,500,000. Pardon me. Now, wages are paid in the month they are incurred. Overhead include 1,500,000 per month for depreciation. Overhead are settled in the month following. 6,500 is to be paid in June for May's overhead. Thank you. Let's go ahead and look at other informations. We said purchases of direct material are paid for in the month of purchase. Opening cash balance in June is 11,750,000. A tax bill of be paid in July. You are required. Calculate the amount of direct material purchases in each month of June, July, and August, and then prepare the cash budget for June, July, and August. Solution first. Normally, we're supposed to bring your solution to the front page for the examiner to easily understand and mark, and your workings as appendix come behind your answers. So that's why you see me doing what I'm doing. I'm bringing solution first instead of working first. So we have ABC Limited, the head of the company. I've labeled it in capital. So I'm underlining the calculation of direct material purchase budget for June. And you have it like this. Material usage, 8,000, 9,000, and 10,000 for each in each of the months. Add closing inventory. It will help you to know the available material. Add closing inventory, please. Add closing inventory. And so we have 3,500, 6,000, and 4,000. Available inventory for the period for June, July, as stated, as you can see. Now, let's open in inventory. All of this information are given in the question. You can easily find them. But the workings will also demonstrate how they come to be. And then you have this. Then this is material purchased for the period. 6,500 was purchased for June, 11,000 for July, 500 for July, and 8,000 for August. Go ahead and wait. You will get to see the working. So, solution number two. I'm going to go back to the question so that you can see how. Now, examiner gave us material usage. 1, 2, 3. All right? Now, and it gave us notes. So, come back to it. This is the figure. Now, he also gave us closing inventory. Take note. Closing inventory in a period is opening inventory in another period. I take it again. Closing inventory in a particular period is opening inventory in another period. So, I'll take time to go back to that information. We have it. This is opening inventory in June. Automatically, this is opening closing inventory in May. This figure here is opening inventory in June. It was closing inventory in May. This figure automatically closing inventory. This opening inventory now. It's gone forever. Then this is opening inventory in July. It will be closing inventory in June. I take this one again. This is opening inventory in August, it will have been June, July, closing inventory. Are we together? And then if this is opening inventory in September, it will have been closing inventory in August. All right? Do you get it? So we can go back to that, how the solution come to be. You can see the figure. So they form closing inventory as I've explained. And that's then whichever was an opening inventory was stated. And that's how to calculate. How to calculate material purchase material usage plus closing inventory less opening inventory. I take it again. Material usage add closing inventory less opening inventories. Thank you. So we're going to do our cash budget now. Cash budget has a formula, so I'm going to stay with the formula first. You bring in cash sales. Examiner told us how it would be. Say it is 10% of cash sales per month. Now, cash sales and receivable collection. I mean, call it debtors collection. I am an IFRS accountant, and I'm trying to ensure that my generation or those who are trained speak the global language. So this is a new name for debtors, receivables. Receivables, all right? So whatever we have that is in the hand of another person, when we collect, we call it receivable collection. Receivable collection, okay? Add the two together, give you total cash inflows. Sometimes you may have other items that will come as inflows, as the examiner may give you, but they must be cash inflows. They must be cash items. Next, take away cash outflows, which are listed. We have wages, overhead, material purchase, which we have calculated by ourselves, tax for the period, and you have a balance. All right. So from the information we have, June had 4,500 because sales in June was 45,000. 10% of that is this. 10% of July figure is also this, and 10% of August is this. All right. Total together. The receivable is next month, 90%. And so this figure was given to us. It came from May. 29,500,000 came from May. So the figure you will have for July receivable will come from June, which is 40,500. Take 4,500 from 45,000, you have 4,500. I hope you get it. So the same you do for the rest. And when you total this item and this, you will have this total. Okay? That's our inflows. So you add this together, you have this together, you have this together, and you have this. We go to the wages. We were told how wages was to be paid for. Wages were paid for in the month they are incurred. And so you have this for figures. Then overhead, I want to go back to the overhead so I can get the information again. The examiner said overhead include 1.5 million, that is 1,500,000. And overhead are set in the month following. That is, if you incur overhead this month, you will pay it next month. I will rush to the working on that overhead. You can see the overhead working here. This is how the overhead has given. But depreciation is not a cash flow item. So it must be negated. It must be deducted from the available overhead incurred so as to get a cash overhead. The actual overhead paid in cash as it is it occurred. All right. See, I brought in May. I brought in June, I brought in July and August. Hence, we know that overhead will be paid in the period following. So we have to calculate what is overhead for May. The examiner also gave us information as may help. So we have those informations given to us. It's our overhead. The material purchase, we also have calculated by ourselves. These are the items. And tax is paid in July, only 1 month, 25 million. That is it. So when you total all of these together, you have total cash outflow 23,500 in June, 56,500 in July, 30,500 in August, and the total 110,500 for the whole period. That is not a problem. Now, how do we know how the net cash flow? First of all, you will have to bring in the balance brought forward. Examiner told us that coming from May to June, 11,750,000 was available. So you bring that item first. Please take note of this structure. The format you have on the board is international and is standard. So you do not need to learn another format. Take note of this. If it's a cash budget you are doing, you do your workings and this is the format. So you bring the balance brought forward first in June, then take total cash inflow for June. Take away the total cash flow for that month, you will have, I will have label A minus B, then you will have got 10,500,000. Add together, you have balance of cash carry forward to the next month. This is it. 22,250 is moved to this point. And then do the same netting. You have an 11 million, all right? and then you have this from a deduction here. Please note this. The total here is 31,750. You cannot carry it up here. Oh, I have to say it again. The total here, 11,250 plus 2,500 is this. But just as we've been doing before, you can't move it here. Why? This is a memorandum column. So what you can do is, what is the actual cash brought forward from May? Bring that one here first. And then the net in August is added to this. It will now give you the total cash flow at the end of August. And then you can see this figure and this are the same. This can now be moved towards September. Thank you for listening to that point. So our workings. How did I gather it? 6 for the month, 10% gone, 90% paid the next month, and then you have the various receivables. I've demonstrated to you how we get over here. Those are the two workings that I want to see in this question. Thank you for listening to question number 3. C part of the question. So when we come up with another update, you will have it. Thank you for watching the video. And like I said, you can always link me up on speedysuccesspro@gmail.com, femirichworld@gmail.com, or I can that link to where it is, the link by the side you watch this video. Best, have a wonderful examination. Thank you.